إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Brothers and sisters in Islam, أخرج الإمام البخاري في صحيحه من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال صلى الله عليه وسلم: قال رجل: لأتصدقن بصدقة. الإمام البخاري compiled a hadith narrated by أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam says, a man from Bani Israel, يعني the context of the hadith, he's from the nations before us. قال لأتصدقن بصدقة. I want to give a sadaqah tonight, a donation, a charity tonight, in secret. Tonight he want to give it in secret, يعني في السر. فخرج بصدقته, he took his صدقة ووضعها في يد سارق, and he placed it in a hand of someone he did not know. Of course it was dark, he just placed it in the hand of the person and he left. فأصبحوا يتحدثون. In the morning the whole community started saying, تصدق الليلة على سارق. You know what? Last night, a thief received the صدقة. حرام يعني. الرجل وصلوا الخبر. He learned about it. فكأنه يعني إيه اكتئب يعني. As if he became upset. Here I am, wanted to give a صدقة, and then I end up giving it to a thief. فقال, he said, لأتصدقن بصدقة. قال أيضا, الحمد لله على سارق. He actually said this, الحمد لله على سارق, no problem, I will try again tonight. لأتصدقن بصدقة, I will give a صدقة. So he went again at night. فخرج بصدقته فوضعها في يد زانية. He placed it in a hand of a prostitute. فأصبحوا يتحدثون. In the morning, the whole town started saying, تصدق الليلة على زانية. You know what? Last night, the prostitute received the صدقة. الرجل فقال الحمد لله على زانية. الحمد لله. ثم قال, then he said, لأتصدقن بصدقة. As if, brothers and sisters in Islam, he believes that his sadaqah was not accepted. That is why he still trying. He said, لأتصدقن بصدقة. I will give a sadaqah. فخرج بصدقته. He went out with his sadaqah. فوضعها في يد غني. He placed it in the hand of the wealthiest man in town. Rich. فأصبحوا يتحدثون. In the morning they started saying, تصدق الليلة على غني. Last night, the wealthiest person in town received the sadaqah. يعني الرجل في بعض الروايات من اكتئابه, because of his disappointment, he went to sleep. فرأى رؤيا. He saw a dream, a vision يعني. يعني another wording, إن النبي, the prophet of the time, came and told him and comforted him. Another wording that جاءه ملك, وهذا يعني ماشي في الأمم السابقة. An angel came to him and actually spoke to him and comforted him. And here is what he said to him. يا هذا, O so and so, إن الله قد قبل صدقتك. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has accepted your sadaqah. أما صدقتك على السارق. As for your sadaqah for the thief, فلعله يستعف عن السرقة. He was stealing because he was in need. And stealing was the only resort for him. And now your sadaqah sufficed him. He's not going to steal anymore. وأما صدقتك على الزانية فلعلها تستعف. As for your sadaqah, for the prostitute, you know what? Sharhu. The same thing. She was doing this because she was in need. And no one helped her. That is why she did that job. And now, because of your sadaqah, she's stopping. وَأَمَّا صَدَقَتُكَ عَلَى الْغَنِيِّ. As for the wealthy and the rich, كان بخيلا مسيكا. He's stingy. He never thought about spending in the cause of Allah. And when he saw, لما رأى واحد طلع بالليل يدي صدقة, هذا, by seeing you, now he's gonna start spending in the cause of Allah. A fascinating story, is it? Brothers and sisters in Islam, ورد هذا الحديث في باب الزكاة في صحيح البخاري, فضل الصدقة. والقرآن, when the Quran spoke about giving صدقة, spending in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he called it to be a trade which will never fail. Will never fail. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَتْلُونَ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ وَأَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةِ وَأَنْفَقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ سِرًّا وَعَلَانِيَةً يَرْجُونَ تِجَارَةً لَنْ تَبُور. Indeed, those who recite the book of Allah and establish the salah and spend in the cause of Allah, they are trading in a trade that will never fail. نعم, في الدنيا لما تنفق في سبيل الله, when you spend in the cause of Allah in this world, you're going to be giving back. And I know this is a little bit, come on, Sheikh, what do you mean? Yes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَمَا أَنْفَقْتُمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ فَهُوَ يُخْلِفُهُ. And whatever you spend in the cause of Allah, Allah will replace it for you. ويعني لأن الأمر برضو صعب على النفس. It's difficult to يعني believe this. أقسم النبي على هذا الموضوع. والنبي ليس من عادته القسم, هو يبشر, يعطي البشرة, give the glad tidings وخلاص, لكن يقسم على ثلاثة أقسم عليهم. نبيك يقسم, your messenger took an oath on this. Three things, because come on Sheikh, Allah is going to give 5,000, Allah is going to give it back. Yes, yes, he said صلى الله عليه وسلم كما في حديث أبي كبش الأنماري رضي الله عنه والحديث في سنن الترمذي, ثلاثة أقسم عليهم, three things I'm willing to take an oath on, ما نقص مال من صدقة. Your wealth will never decrease because of a صدقة. يعني I tell you out of personal experience, بفضل الله I do a lot of fundraisings. When I revisit communities, when I say $10,000, I know who's the person who's going to give $10,000. You know who? The one who gave it last time. The one who gave him the $10,000 last fundraising. Because he's seen it. He's seen it. He now seen it. You see, we're not believing it because we have not tried it. And in order to try it, you have to believe it. That is why the word sadaqah derives from whether you are believing in that or not. Sadaqah, min al-sidq. Hal anta tusaddiq bihada or la or no? Do you believe in this or not? Well, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, kama fi hadith Abi Malik al-Ash'ari, fi sahih Muslim, was-sadaqatu burhan. And the sadaqah is an evidence. فسبحان الله الصدقة يعني you get it back in this dunya. Add to this, it cleanses you from stinginess. By the way, we're all stingy by default. We like to withhold. You like to keep. By default, by the way. I mean by default, by your nafs is fashioned to be stingy, in the sense, يعني, if you don't purify it, لابد من تزكيتها. قال تعالى, Allah سبحانه وتعالى says, قل لو أنتم تملكون خزائن رحمة ربي إذا لأمسكتم خشية الإنفاق وكان الإنسان قتورا. هذا سورة الإسراء. If you possess that storage, الخزائن of the mercy of Allah, you will withhold. That's mine. And by default, you're stingy. So when you spend, you cleanse. لأن البخل destruction. إياكم والشح. There you be aware of stinginess. It destroyed the nations before you. والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يعني لما قرأ هذه الآية على أصحابه, when he recited this verse to his companions, لن تنالوا البر حتى تنفقوا مما تحبون. You see, you claim that you love Allah, I don't doubt this, and we know that you love money. بنص القرآن, أنت تحب الإنسان, يحب المال بنص القرآن. قال تعالى وتحبون المال حبا جما. And you love money so much. وإنه لحب الخير لشديد. الخير هنا مش موطن تزكية, الخير هنا المال. Oh, so you claim that you love Allah, and we know that you love money. So Allah is telling you, you will never be able to attain faith. البر هنا معناها إيمان, faith. Prove this. Until you give that which you love most. So when you give your money, seeking the reward from Allah, for the sake of Allah, it's a testimony that you love Allah more than the wealth, more than the money. ولما سمع هذه الآية أبو طلحة الأنصاري رضي الله عنه كما في صحيح البخاري حديث أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه, when أبو طلحة heard this verse قال يا رسول الله, he said, O messenger of Allah, إن أحب مالي إلي بئر بيرحاء, the most beloved wealth to me is this garden, I want to give it for Allah. Again, you're testifying, you're proving your iman, your faith. Spending, brothers and sisters in Islam, in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is a trade that will never fail, because when they deliver you underneath the ground, your wealth leaves you, your money leaves you. بنص السنة, بنص الحديث, three things follow the son of Adam to his grave, two things return and one stays. Your money, your children, your hasanat or sayyat follow you to the grave. Your money returns, your children returns, but your deeds will stay with you. وحتى في النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لما جاء حديث the two angels coming waking up the deceased to question him, listen to this, it says القرآن والصلاة by his head, الصيام by his right side, الزكاة by his left side, and his صدقة by his feet, and the other good deeds. So when the two angels come and wake him up from his head side, the salah, don't wake him up from here, wake him for the fitna of the qabr, who is your lord, what is your deen. هذا في الأصف حديث أبي هريرة, don't wake him up from here, he used to pray on time and recite the Quran, find another direction, they go to the right side fasting, say no, sadaqa, zakah, left, no, sadaqa, no. At the end they call upon him because he has to wake up, it's ordained. But look, your deeds. وذلك النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول ابن آدم مالي 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 مالي. The son of Adam says, my money, my money, my money, my money. What is your money, son of Adam? What? Huh? What you eat? That's what you use the money for, whether you like it or not. Maybe you could do some extra stuff, that's fine. But this is what you use the money for. What you eat, digest, and a'azzakum Allah, you go to and eat again. And what you wear, wash, wear, wash, wear, gets old by another one. خلاص. عربية ومش عارف ايه ماشي زينة. And what you spend and it stays for you. ولذلك النبي صلى هذا المعنى, شوف النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم when he said to عائشة رضي الله عنها, when he was given a sheep and he told her slaughter it and give it out to the poor and the needy, عائشة رضي الله عنها knows that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم loves the shoulder, then when she kept it for him, when he returned صلى الله عليه وسلم, what happened to the sheep, عائشة? You know what she said? Ya Rasulallah, all of it is gone but the shoulder. You know what he said to her? Ya Aisha, all of it stayed but the shoulder. يعني سبحان الله يا أخي, we give 15% social security. I'm not saying don't pay, you have to pay your social security, it's the laws of the land, no question about it. Don't get me in trouble here. At the age of 60, تفضل يا سيدي, age of 60. طب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول لك أعمار أمتي بين 60 و70. The lifespan of my ummah between 60 and 70 years old. طب قبلني بقى لما that's the overall, يعني the average 60-70. If you pass, ما شاء الله, mercy. فimagine you're giving this to Allah. شوف انظر إلى هذا الحديث. إن الله يقبل الصدقة من أحدكم بيمينه. Allah سبحانه وتعالى takes the sadaqah from you with his right hand, and both of his hands are right. ثم يربيها كما يربي أحدكم فلوة. And then he raises it up for you, increases it for you, grows for you, like you bring up, like you nourish a little horse, baby horse. In the day of resurrection, when it's hot, you're desperate for a shade. صدقتك is your shade. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم المؤمن تحت ظل صدقته يوم القيامة حتى يقضي الله بين الخلائق. The believer will be shaded under his صدقه. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم actually said that some of your صدقه will be as huge as a mountain, as huge as a tree, as huge as this. فyou choose your صدقه. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وآله وصحبه وسلم. في معنى يا إخوة في هذا الحديث يغيب عن كل من لا يتدبر هذا الحديث. There is a message in this hadith that you have to ponder to get it. And I will do my best to present it to you. But I want to present it to you in a context of something happened in the community here last week. Two young men, teenagers, youth, they found themselves walking to the house of the neighbor and vandalizing it, trying to break through, to steal, to get some money. Muslim teenagers. They damaged the value of almost $500. But here is the interesting piece that really aches, that the neighbor refused to press charges. Non-Muslim. You see the hadith? We got the thief stealing and the prostitute committing adultery because the rich is what? هذا هو المعنى في الحديث. ده الحديث. الحديث. This hadith is for this cause يا أخي. نعم فضل الصدقة والكلام ده هذا جميل. But this is the message out of this hadith. ولا تلقوا بأيديكم إلى التهلكة. Don't think that because you're wealthy, you're better off, you're still a Muslim. And you know what? What happened in this week is in your neck too. Brothers and sisters in Islam, it's been an interesting experience trying to get the community to understand the challenges that we face. Dear brothers from Pakistan, Afghanistan, from the Arabia, you've been here for 60 years, 70 years. Alhamdulillah, you're well established. You got your Somali Ethiopian brothers who arrived 20 years back. They went through hell to make it here. They came from a war zone. And I'm sorry, my brothers, if I'm mentioning ethnic backgrounds here, but like I always say, Wallahi, الرائد لا يكذب أهله. By Allah, I will never compromise the message. The moment that I do this, I will go drive a taxi. These brothers have children, youth. Teaching them Islam, 80%, teaching them Islam 20% out of the day is not the solution. Is not the solution. We must have education for these children 100% to be able to make a difference in their lives. We must. You have no choice, ya akhi. This halfway solution is not gonna work. Wallahi, is not gonna work. Ya ikhwa, there are places in Columbus, Ohio, that the police themselves, the security cannot enter because of gang activities by Muslims. Muslims. I was invited to one of these events to speak to the brothers. I can give you evidence. So, the bottom line behind this hadith that if the wealthy of this community do not stand to help their brethren, you're going to end up with a problem at your hand. I'm telling you, if nothing is done here, and I'm not speculating, I'm being realistic, if nothing is done in Denver, Colorado, because of the amount of migration we're getting to this area, in 10 years, you're going to have gang activities nearby your masjid. And I'm telling you, the moment it reaches there, I'm done. What are you going to do about it? That is why we're talking about a community center. Community center. You know, when I spoke to Gaira Stevie, Sheikh Yusuf, and I explained to him the situation. Listen, this is what we're facing. He said, you know what? Sheikh, I'm coming this weekend on my expense to support your community. Him, Mutahir Sabri, a brother, his name is a blind Muslim revert out of this world. Harris, Abu Hafsa, they said, well, come, and you know what? We're going to broadcast the fundraising live so that you can accept donations from nationwide places. So they're coming to help you, brothers. They are coming to help you. But are we willing to help ourselves? Don't you have a hard time those 2 weeks that what I'm going to do with my children? You have them in your hand, and if you let them go, Google, pornography. Community center. Mom, can I go outside? Dad, can I go outside? Hang around. Weed. Come on, don't be naive here. Don't pretend. We're talking about a community center. What is a community center, brothers and sisters in Islam, for which we're raising funds for this Sunday, June 3rd at 6 o'clock in the Mariot? And please, even if you don't have money, come. Come, we need your dua. All we need is your dua. If you don't want to give, come. We just want your dua, ya akhi. We just want your dua. That's all we need. And Allah will send the help. But this is what we have at our hands in this community, whether you like it or not. We don't have education 100%. And it's very unfortunate that a lot of the parents do not even know, they are not educated enough. And I'm not blaming them, I'm not ridiculing them, I'm just stating the facts, because they don't know how to educate their children here because they are immigrants. When their children are at home, they don't know how to protect them, they don't know how to address them, they don't know how to talk to them, because they were born at a different time and they've been here. The brother from Christian View Academy calls me and he tells me, Sheikh, by Allah, we had a parent-teacher conference or some sort of a function for the parents. The staff was more than the parents. We don't have parents who are educated enough. And again, I'm not bringing anybody, I'm being realistic, to help their youth. We are the solution, the community. We are. Today, for example, instead of worrying about your child, you can drop him into a football field, soccer field. That's what we're talking about. Gymnasium, swimming pools. Are you aware that your women go bi-weekly and swim in a place? They take off their clothes in a place. I know it's all women, but Allah knows best. Ya ikhwa, wallahi, two segments of this community have been neglected dramatically. The sisters, the mothers, and the youth. They've been neglected, I'm sorry, they are. And if we do not do something about it, I'm telling you, this is a betrayal of our trust. That is why, listen, I'm not fond of just making a scene here every week, okay? Wallahi, I would love to see things walk in the right direction. And I will just come and do my job, lead the salah, give a lecture, and go home. That's what I want to do. But things are not going in the right direction. We have $150,000 from the parking lot this week. Inshallah, we want to raise at least 200,000. By Ramadan, we should have 750,000, hopefully, inshallah. If we see collaboration from other institutions, we sat with them and we spoke with them. Listen, this is the project. When I brought this project up to the Shura, they said, Sheikh, you have to talk to other communities first. I said, please. We called the whole community into a meeting. And you know what? We invited all of them to these meetings to talk about it. Some of them resigned. Resigned from what? I don't have anything. You know, inshallah we're going to do it. Inshallah we're going to do it. Bidnillahi ta'ala. So we thought, let's hold off. Who is in charge of this? Who is responsible? Because the whole argument in these meetings, who's taking the lead? Is it CMS? Is it CPA? Is it Noor? Is it... Okay, you know what? Just leave this alone for now. Let's just worry about raising the funds, finding a land, and then we can talk about who can take the lead. Some of the brothers are wondering, what is going on with the Ihsan Academy, Sheikh? The Ihsan Academy is part of that vision. And we would like Crescent View to join in. We're going to have businesses that can sustain the education so we can teach Islam 100%. Not rely on a whole program. I don't know if you're aware of this or not. CVA is funded by a program called HOPE. You cannot teach Islam. You offer optional Islamic studies, Quran, after hours. After the children are consumed. That is not the solution. Brothers and sisters in Islam, like I always say, It's amana, and this is the situation. Alhamdulillah, we're having brothers came from out of town. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send the support from here. We're going to broadcast our fundraising and open the phone lines nationwide for people to send us help. But this is your community. This is your community. Inshallah, tonight myself and Sheikh Yusuf Astes and Abu Hafsa will be in Boulder to promote the event. Tomorrow, inshallah, will be in Masjid al-Ikhlas to promote the event. We have brothers who are delivering khutbas. Abu Hafsa, Yusuf Astes is in Masjid al-Nur delivering khutbas, mobilizing the community. This is the first step. And you know what? It's a die-hard. It's a die-hard project. And you gotta have a heart for it. And inshallah, by the help and support of Allah, I will never give it up. I will never stop alerting my brothers about what is wrong going in here, in this community. I will never. Like I said, the moment I stop, I'll drive a cab, inshallah. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه، وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وأقم الصلاة.